Hey guys, it's James, and today we're going to look at problem 6 in part D of the Chemistry 151-1 Unit Conversions worksheet. So the problem reads, the USDA recommends that a person's sodium intake be limited to 2,400 milligrams. Table salt is 39.33% sodium. How many grams of table salt can Jenny consume without surpassing this limit? Assume there are no other sources of sodium in her diet. So first we're going to convert 2,400 milligrams of sodium into grams. So we'll start with the units that we're given. And we should know that for every 1,000 milligrams of sodium, you have 1 gram of sodium, because 1,000 milligrams is equivalent to 1 gram. So when you divide the units of milligrams of sodium by milligrams of sodium, those units will cancel out, and your answer will be left in grams of sodium. So we'll go ahead and do that right here. We have 2,400 milligrams of sodium divided by 1,000 milligrams of sodium. And sorry about the fraction. So what we really have is 2.4 grams of sodium. Next, we have to do something with this fraction right here. The problem tells us that table salt is 39.33% sodium. 39.33% is equivalent to 39.33 divided by 100. We don't have any units on this fraction right here, so we're going to have to go ahead and add units to it. If table salt is 39.33% sodium, what we can do is say that for every 39.33 grams of sodium that we have 100 grams of table salt or sodium chloride. And I'll just make a quick note right here that NaCl is equal to table salt. Sodium chloride is just the molecular formula for table salt. But once you have this unit conversion up here, you can plug it in over here. And just like we did in the previous part, if we're starting out with grams of sodium, we're going to go ahead and put that unit on the bottom, so that when we divide out, those units cancel. So we'll do this calculation as well. And we have 2.4 times 100 divided by 39.33, 6.10. I'm just going to say 6.1 grams of NaCl, or you can say 6.1 grams is the amount of table salt that Jenny can consume without surpassing the sodium intake level. And that's how you do problem number 6. I will see you guys next time.